We hear a lot of misconceptions about entrepreneurs as people with great ideas, be it corporate entrepreneurs or new venture founders, that this one great idea can lead to major success. In practice, actually, this is not exactly true. There is no such thing as a good idea up front. There are only implemented ideas and the ideas that were never tried and never implemented. Also, in my own practice and in the practice of entrepreneurship scholarships, I see lots and lots of examples of really great ideas never seen the light of the day because nobody tried to implement them and learned along the way. And simultaneously, there are lots of bad ideas that ultimately got tried, then improved, then the founders would make some pivots in order to make this work. So, there is no great entrepreneurial ideas up front. There are only implemented ideas and not implemented ideas. Essential part of entrepreneurial thinking is learning by doing. Market is the only authority. It is not the professor, not investors, not venture capitalists, not somebody else who is the authority judging whether idea is good or bad. That's why we have to be really, really careful about, for example, all these competitions of best entrepreneurial ideas, because ultimately judges might not be the best authority to judge entrepreneurial ideas. The only real judge, the only real authority is market. It is all about whether your innovation is accepted by the market or not. And for this, entrepreneurial ideas have to be, so you have to engage in learning by doing and in planning. On the one hand, you have to do your homework in advance. If your idea is like obviously crappy on paper, most likely on in the market it will still remain crappy. But once you have an idea that seems to be working on paper, your financial projections seems to show that if implemented, the idea is going to fly, then you have to give it a try. You have to validate your idea, something that is also essential part of entrepreneurial thinking, this validation part, learning by doing. So, in summary, no great ideas up front, market is the only authority, and you have to do planning and doing, and learn by doing. Let me give you some examples of how entrepreneurs pivoted their ideas from what was initially and what proved to be not that successful. The first company, Tiffany & Company, they started as a provider of stationery and office equipment in 1837. Only in about 20 years, they moved to jewelry, and this made Tiffany & Company what Tiffany & Company is today. But again, they started elsewhere and they were able to pivot into more profitable niche. Colgate, something all these toothpastes that we know, they actually started producing toothpaste only 74 years after the company founding, and initially Colgate was producing soaps and candles and different things related to candles, like all these aroma materials, and only later they moved to toothpaste. So there is no such thing as a great idea. There are only ideas that were tested and implemented or not. Nokia is beautiful because this case is still ongoing. So it was founded in 1865. It is 150 years old company. It moved across different industries from rubber to paper to electronics to cell phones. And what it is going to do right now, nobody really knows. But there is still a chance that the company will be able to reinvent itself. So again, don't wait for a great entrepreneurial idea. You have to validate. Of course, you have to do your planning, but ultimately, without trying the water, you cannot know for sure whether your idea is good or bad. And even bad ideas can be improved with time, as these three examples demonstrate. One more misconception about entrepreneurial ideas. If we read a lot of popular business press or books, it seems like we might get an impression that brilliant ideas emerge fully formed in the minds of geniuses. So that like there is some thinker who was thinking deeply about like fundamental problem in the world, and this person, he or she, came out with a great idea, and this great idea revolutionized the world. In practice, it is not like that. In practice, you usually have to try. You have to try something that might not initially work, but you have to be persistent, and sooner or later you might get it work. Let me talk about this gentleman. This gentleman is James Watt. A lot of people associate Industrial Revolution with the invention of James Watt of steam engine. In practice, James Watt did not invent steam engine. He simply modified the available at that time steam engines to make them work. You can always look in Wikipedia. It is actually quite interesting story about what exactly he did, but he did some, anyway, we have to pay due credit to him. James Watt was able to make this invention actually work and actually make something valuable to everyone. So, James Watt. His first idea came in 1763. So in 1763 he was asked to fix a broken prior generation steam engine, and when he was working with this steam engine, he actually got an idea about how to improve it, how to make sure that you don't need constant supply of water for steam engine to work. It happened in 1763. In 1765, 2 years down the road, James Watt developed the first prototype. So it took James Watt 2 years in order to get to the first prototype. However, the first commercial product got to the market only in 1776, which is essentially 12 years after the first prototype, or 11 years, I'm sorry, after the first prototype, or 13 years after the first idea. So it took James Watt 13 years from the idea towards first commercial product. 13 years when he had to improve his idea. Actually, his first investor went out of business, got bankrupt. So it was only the second investor into James Watt's enterprise who was able to reap any rewards from James Watt's ideas. So, brilliant ideas don't emerge fully formed in the minds of geniuses, in most cases. In most cases, it is all about rigor and discipline. It is all about key role of customers' insights, trying to understand your customers' pains, your customers' frustrations, and moving from these insights towards improving your design of your solution. Key role here of experimentation and prototyping. So entrepreneurial ideas, usually they are premature. You have to improve them as you're validating, as you're doing experimentation and prototyping.